public speaking course online. Think about it. It's the day of your long-awaited informative speech. You've researched your topic, written an outline, and practiced your speech for days. Yet instead of standing in front of your classmates, you're sitting in your dorm room, alone, speaking to a camera. With the rise of technology in today's society, online courses are gaining popularity in higher education institutions around the world. Nick Leonardopoulos, assistant teaching professor at Drexel University, reported in his 2010 article titled Teaching and Learning Public Speaking Online that in the fall of 2007, almost 4 million students in the U.S. were enrolled in an online course. And that was 10 years ago. The number of students taking online courses has been increasing ever since. He also explained that more than 96% of the nation's higher education institutions offer some form of online learning opportunities. While there's been a significant amount of research regarding the effectiveness of online courses, there's been less research specifically focusing on online public speaking courses. In this speech, I'd like to discuss both the advantages and the disadvantages associated with speech courses being offered online at the undergraduate level. There are a number of advantages associated with online public speaking courses. The first advantage I'd like to focus on is convenience. As with other online courses, students enrolled in online public speaking courses are able to work through much of the course activities at their own pace. While there are still deadlines for assignments, speeches, and exams, students are able to complete these assignments at times that are convenient for them. This provides students with a greater amount of flexibility to work around their busy schedules. It also allows students with families, jobs, and other commitments the opportunity to enroll. According to researchers Kelly Bergstrand and Scott Savage, who analyzed student evaluations of online courses in their 2013 article, the convenience of online courses may encourage participation and learning, resulting in improved academic performance. Another benefit related to the convenience of online courses is that students don't all need to be in the same geographical location. Classes can foster cross-cultural learning by connecting students all over the globe. Students can learn a lot from their classmates' speeches and discussion board posts, especially when they possess a wide range of ideas and opinions due to their unique geographical location. Another advantage of online speech courses is that they incorporate important skills regarding online communication that may not be covered in the traditional course. Being able to communicate effectively online is more important now than ever. Many jobs and graduate schools even require online Skype interviews for admission. Students who have taken an online speech course are likely to be more confident during these interviews than students who have taken traditional face-to-face courses, just because they've had practice speaking in front of a camera, where students in traditional courses may feel awkward and uncomfortable due to the lack of experience. When students enter the workforce, almost all professions require some knowledge of technology. Alex Huebner, lead instructor of the Online Communication and Presence course at FSU, elaborated on the importance of these skills taught in the online course. Alex explained, as companies move toward video interviews through things like Skype, especially in the early rounds of the employee selection process, it will be important for job seekers to be comfortable and professional in front of a camera. He also stated that in a shift towards a service-oriented, mobilized gig economy, being able to interact online and use video tools, like the tools used in the online public speaking courses, might be an important feature of someone's job, especially as video technology plays an increasingly important role in our world today. The course also provides other practical knowledge about how to present oneself online in a smart and positive way. Traditional face-to-face speech courses may not include information on these topics. However, helping college students become smarter about what they post online is extremely important and may positively impact students' ability to find jobs in the future. As you can see, there are a number of advantages associated with taking an online speech course. However, let's take a look at the other side of the situation. There are a number of disadvantages that come with taking a public speaking course online. One of the biggest and most obvious disadvantages is that students in these courses do not gain experience speaking in front of a live audience. This may lead to increased anxiety in future public speaking events. In an article titled Lessons Learned from Teaching Public Speaking Online, it published in 2004, Trudy Hansen and Jason Teven, professors who performed a study comparing online and face-to-face sections of a public speaking course, wrote that online students reported having higher levels of communication apprehension than did their face-to-face counterparts. Students also do not gain experience dealing with the anxiety that comes with speaking in front of an audience. A lot of students take the online public speaking course for the sole purpose of avoiding speaking in front of others. However, confronting and overcoming the nerves and anxiety that accompany face-to-face public speaking is something that can only be done by actually doing it. Another issue with not speaking in front of a live audience is that students don't learn the necessary skills required to adapt to the audience throughout the speech. When speeches are pre-recorded and uploaded online, students aren't able to interact with their audience. They're not able to adjust their tone, their rate of speech, or even provide extra clarification based on audience feedback. Another disadvantage is that students in online speech courses do not have an opportunity to create relationships with their classmates. Public speaking is a nerve-wracking and stressful course for many students, but getting to know your classmates and your instructor can be helpful in reducing some of those negative feelings. Alex Huebner believes that interacting and forming bonds with other students in the same situation can also enhance future public speaking performance. He stated that it is so much different giving a speech to a sympathetic audience in a classroom full of students going through the same agonizing hell of public speaking than it is to give, for example, an in-person talk where you're being judged much more harshly by a superior for a promotion or a raise. Huebner's statement suggests that students who choose to take the course online are at a disadvantage because they're not able to sympathize with and receive support from fellow students. While I don't have any experience taking an online speech course, speaking from my own experience in Mark Ziegler's face-to-face course, my classmates and I became very close, which I think helped reduce a lot of the anxiety associated with speaking in front of the group. So as you can see, there are a number of disadvantages, including not speaking in front of a live audience and not forming relationships with other students. So now that we've discussed both the advantages and the disadvantages associated with taking a public speaking course online, I'd like to invite all of you to share your ideas on the topic through the Q&A session. So just to start us off, how many of you have actually taken the public speaking course online, either here or at another university? Okay, so we've all taken it in person. Does anyone have any questions to start us off? John Michael?
Do you think that it would be a better, or maybe not better, a decent idea to classify the online speaking class as something different? Because you mentioned that it was geared towards, a portion of it was geared towards how people present themselves on the internet, which that's becoming more and more important. And maybe if the class was not presented as the online version of this speech class, but rather online communication for when Twitter is a thing, like how to not be a garbage person on Twitter, and like,
So the name of the course is actually Online Communication and Presence.
All right.
But a lot of people kind of refer to it as the online public speaking course just because it still does satisfy the oral competency requirement.
So do you think it should, though, or should it be shown as like, no, this is a different thing, filling a different set of requirements
It's hard to say because I think a lot of the things that are discussed in that class are really important and should be taught. But it's a matter of, should that be counting for the same thing as a class where you're giving speeches, or should it be a separate kind of class entirely, focusing on, you know, online interviews and posting things on Facebook and things like that? And if it is an entirely different course, should it be a required course for students? Should it be another requirement like the oral competency requirement? Or should it, you know, still count for that same thing? But yeah, that's a good point. Okay.
Do you think that the way that our society is sort of trending towards online communication, that we'll eventually move towards a two-part requirement of online literacy and communications alongside the public speaking requirement?
Yeah, so making it a requirement to do both.
Sort of a two-part
requirement. Because technology is becoming so important that, you know, I don't think we'll ever be at the point where we don't have to speak in front of people, you know, like live with an audience, but I think more and more, you know, in a variety of professions, we're going to have to be able to communicate online as well. So it might be a good idea to, you know, either have the class do both, kind of combine them, or make a requirement to take each class.
That would be a good idea. Going off of the question comment thing, for the class that would be predominantly the online presence focus, do you think that would be okay taught online, or like would it still have the same advantages and disadvantages of being taught online, or would it be better in class?
I think if the class was just focused on online presence and it was really based on, you know, things that John Michael was saying, like posting, tweeting and posting things on Facebook and stuff like that, I think something like that could be taught effectively online. hard when you're actually teaching, you know, how to speak to make that be online. Dr.
Nick is probably most familiar because he got online to find a YouTube video of watching the students' speeches, but it seems as if, as you go through the ones that are posted online, that about maybe now a third still seem to have this requirement that the professor says, you have to do your speech in front of six or more people. So they start with the camera scanning the six people,
yeah.
And then it goes to the speaker,
mm-hmm.
right? So some kind of compromise position is articulated
yeah.
in those instructions for those particular classes.
Mm-hmm.
What do you feel about, what do you think, does that hybrid work or not,
yeah.
and what do you think?
Yeah, so I was kind of basing mine off of, I had Alex send me the syllabus for the course.
Mm-hmm.
And that syllabus didn't say anything about having to have a certain amount of people in the audience, so I don't know if there is a specific requirement that he kind of announces in the class, but...
No, actually, there was when they submitted it to the university.
Yeah.
Then it's changed.
Because I expected to see that on the syllabus, you know, like how many people
yeah.
you have to speak in front of.
I think they might require to... You looked at it closely, but it might be required that six people online have to look
yeah,
at it and
I
respond,
think that's
which
I
is
saw.
A different kind of...
They all kind of were assigned to groups, and you had to watch more speeches, I think, and critique them. But yeah, so I was expecting to see in the syllabus that they would have to create an audience, but I could also see.
Have you watched any of the other kind?
Which ones?
The ones where they stand.
I've seen
audience.
Some of them, yeah. But I think, I mean, yeah, that's kind of a hybrid where it's an online class, but you're still speaking in front of an audience. But the problem with that is that. You know, the people that are watching the speech are most likely going to be friends, roommates,
yeah.
like, you know, significant others. It's going to be people that they're familiar with and have close relationships with. Whereas it's a completely different experience standing in front of a class of people you're semi-familiar with compared to standing, like, in the living room of your apartment
yeah.
with your audience.
No, Dana, you're absolutely
couch.
Right. I mean, about half the time
yeah.
when it's scanned, it's like, six very bored fraternity brothers who
yeah.
were promised a beer if they just sat there for 6 minutes,
yeah.
right? Or the other is mom and grandma and you know my niece and my neighbors.
And in real life public speaking situations, you're not going to get to you know pick and choose your audience. So I think it does help because you are giving that speech in front of people. But it's not a realistic situation when you're just talking to your fraternity brothers or sorority sisters. Jisoo?
How can students get feedback about vocal, voice, or tone, or this face expression? Because this kind of things, we can understand what the professors say, but it's not easy to correct this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so like I was saying, when you're uploading a video, just you know, submitting it to Blackboard and people are watching it after the speech has already been done. You can't really make those changes on the spot. People might comment on those things in the you know in their critiques, then you can fix it for the next speech. But it is really difficult when you're just speaking to a camera to be able to you know make adjustments and those type of things during the speech. Samantha,
could a student like they get the advantage of him? Picking their audience so they don't have to ever deal with that like hostile
mm-hmm.
audience situation. But also, going off of what you're saying, couldn't you just like watch your own video and be like, oh, that was horrible. Everybody stay here for 5 seconds.
Yeah.
I'm gonna redo
yeah.
that. And so then, you know, I don't know. I feel like it's so much easier.
Yeah, that brings up another point because, you know, people can, they can record it multiple times, they can edit it, they can, you know, not do it all in one take, which I think you're supposed to, but you can, you know, stop it, start it over, which isn't realistic because in a real speaking situation, I can't just decide at the end of this, they're like, oh, that was horrible, let me just do it again. Like, it already happened, you've already done it. So it is a weird situation because, you know, they do have, they're at a disadvantage because they're not practicing, you know, how to speak in front of others, but they're at an advantage because they can redo it and receive a better grade than they maybe would have if it was live. Julia?
A suggestion for curriculum requirements, I think that it would be okay for that to be the substitute for people or students whose majors isn't like communications, but
mm-hmm.
I think for
us, since we will be dealing with in-person and online, it definitely should be required to take both.
Yeah, so maybe have certain requirements based on the major for which class would count.
Yeah, because like in undergrad, it was so many humanities classes where I could pick and choose, like I didn't have to take the one that they suggested.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think that would be fair to say everybody has to take these two, but if it's beneficial to them in the future, then it should be required.
Yeah, and I know for certain majors, there are, you know, other courses outside of these two or two or three that can count for that requirement.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not sure if there's certain majors that restrict the online one or require it. So I'm not sure about that. Kenny?
So I was thinking of like proctored exams just now.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, an exam takes, you know, half an hour to an hour. If they did, and I know this one's like specifically online communications.
Yeah.
But if they did want to host like a speech class that was like mostly like that was online, but you also wanted to get the public speaking factor into it,
mm-hmm.
I feel like you could get like a little proctor situation going and have like one day where they all go in and give their speeches in front of each other, in
mm-hmm.
front of a full crowd. Probably would take like half an hour to an hour, just like a normal test would.
Yeah.
And I don't know, you'd have. Like,
yeah, and in my research, I did see some schools that gave an option to where you could come in, you know, you take the class online, you could come into the class if you wanted to do your speech in front of the other students.
Yeah.
But the other option would be kind of creating your own audience, having in these, you know, 3 to 6 people in your audience. So I think that would be a better way to go about the course, because they'd still get that experience speaking in front of people, but they could take the rest of the course online.
It'd be really hard to facilitate the learning, though, of public speaking.
Yeah.
Without being in class, like,
right. Yeah, and then that would kind of also restrict it to people who could only, like, who were near the school to come and give the speech. But the one school that I saw, I believe it was Drexel University, which I had an article from one of the professors. They gave that option, so where you could come in and do your speech in class. Nick?
Kind of to that point, the class here at FSU is asynchronous, right? So you upload a video and no one's really watching you at that time.
Right.
Do you think that they could make a class that was synchronous? So it's an online meeting time, so everyone
mm-hmm.
logs into like Blackboard and collaborate at 6 o'clock in the evening.
Yeah.
And then you kind of watch everyone's speeches. You're not all together, but you're still as present as you can be online.
Right. Yeah, and it would still be live, so it
yeah.
would still kind of mimic this situation,
yeah,
and you
exactly.
couldn't redo it. I think that would be a better option if everyone logged on and was watching it live, rather than, you know, recording it, editing it, uploading it later for people to see, you know, not at that time. I think it would be a better way. John Michael?
Yeah, I don't know. You said streaming tech being what it is, you
mm-hmm.
can easily accomplish that and also have some form of chat interaction to be able to, in real time, interact with these people. That might even, if you're gearing it towards specific online communication, you can probably develop lessons around dealing with a chat window while you're live talking, because that's a thing.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I think it would be good to incorporate ways to make it live and less
mm-hmm.
of an asynchronous
right.
course. Jeremiah?
Kind of what we were talking about before, about maybe like two different classes for public speaking and online presence. I know a lot of people, and one of my roommates included, all of their job interviews where they like first had to submit a video of themselves like answering specific questions.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess like that just seems like it's really needed for like most people that are graduating having to do that.
Yeah, and so it is very relevant. I think they're important skills that they're teaching in that class by, you know, teaching how to present yourself online, how to do a Skype interview, things like that. So I think it is very important. And so I don't know if the face-to-face classes kind of want to incorporate that into their class or keep them separate but require both. But I think those could definitely be options, because I think most students who are going to be graduating soon looking for a job are going to have to experience speaking in front of a computer. Anyone have any other questions or comments? Wrap up? Okay. All right, so today I think we had a really good discussion about the advantages and the disadvantages of taking an online public speaking course. We brought up a lot of points, advantages, including convenience and being able to, one second. experience aspect of it, and then being able to learn about ways that technology really is important in our lives, and how that technology, being able to use that technology, can help you for job interviews and you know, potential jobs in the future. We also looked at some of the disadvantages, which included not speaking in front of a live audience and not being able to form relationships with your classmates. So those were all great points to bring up. I think Nick brought up a great point of the course being asynchronous, and we can still keep it online, but make it more of a synchronous class, make it live, incorporate a system where everyone would log on at the same time to watch the speeches, you can kind of get feedback live. I think that would be more beneficial. Or as Kenny said, you know, having most of the class online, but bringing students together to present their speeches. I think those would both be great ways to kind of compromise and give students the right amount of public speaking knowledge and skills, whether they take the class online or in person. Finally, I hope that this discussion gave you some ideas for how you could maybe change the course or adapt the course, whether you're a TA for the online course